Welcome to Longjiang Gymnasium, where we go into day three of competition in judo at the Nanjing 2014 Youth Olympic Games. It's been a wonderful games for all the competitors, all of them aged between 15 and 18. They must turn 15 as a minimum in this calendar year. And all the competitors through the first couple of days have been competing in great spirit and with great achievement as well. Today we have two weight divisions, the women's under 78 kilograms division with 10 entries in all, and also the men's under 100 kilogram division. Now there are just four entries in the men, as you can imagine at this age. 100 kilograms is very large for an 18-year-old, so only four entries taking part in the men's 100 kilogram division, under 100 kilogram division. There will only be one bronze medal awarded for the men's weight category, whereas for the women's weight category with 10 entries there will be two bronze medals, as well as the one silver and one gold. The crowd of pouring up the stairs just outside the gymnasium, coming through the security and ticket areas, and making their way in just in the last 10 minutes. A rush of people coming in through the security area and up the stairs. A lot of enthusiasm. Handed a bottle of water by the security team here, the volunteers. And what a wonderful job the volunteers are doing too. A Chinese visitor, one of the girls from possibly around Nanjing there, with the mascot in her hand for the games. Of course, the team members, the support teams have been here in numbers, and competitors from the last couple of days are here to support their fellow countrymen and women. And it's been an excellent atmosphere here in the Longjiang Gymnasium. Last day of individual competition today. We'll have preliminary rounds in the first session and then the medal session later. The first bout in the women's under 78 kilogram division features Naomi De Bruin of Australia against Wang Jiyuan of Chinese Taipei. And that first bout is not far away. Very soon we'll have the introduction of the officials and the athletes. An iPad or a phone is obviously almost an essential item these days. Everyone's keeping up to date with the latest from the games and sending messages home. First competitors are ready to move to mat one. All competition today on mat one, with only two weight divisions and reduced numbers of entries. Only one mat in operation, not two as we had on the first couple of days. Competition under the auspices and rules of the International Judo Federation, with repechage in action. Losers in the main draw drop back into the repechage with a chance to compete for a bronze medal. In the under 78 weight division, from Chinese Taipei, in the blue, Wang Jiyuan, and in the white, Naomi De Bruin of Australia. Competition underway. De Bruin is 18 years old. She's in the white and she goes for the throw but misses. And quickly, Wang from Chinese Taipei takes over, goes for the hold and applies it. It's not as yet in place. The referee keeping a close eye on them. Can Wang secure a hold? De Bruin in early trouble here. She seems to have broken it. She has. She slipped out. She was aggressive in intent, but quickly found the counter-attack from Wang. One to be reckoned with. Yes, Wang is 17 years old. De Bruin a year older. And just a little taller as well, you'll notice. She goes with the legwork. Wang started to move into the shoulder throw, but then quickly realized she didn't have the grip and the force wasn't with her, and very quickly retreated from that position so that she wasn't counter-attacked. She's got the grip and she goes again looking for the position, Wang, but couldn't get it. The Australian in the white would like to be a special needs teacher later in her life as her career unfolds. She goes for the hip throw here. Can't bring Wang over. Naomi De Bruin in the white from Sydney, Australia. 17-year-old Wang Yu Yuan from Chinese Taipei in the blue. These are 4-minute bouts, and here's possibly a stranglehold from Wang. She is in the dominant position, locks the legs around to secure the position. Now the referee keeping a very close eye on the hold. Still Osakomi not called, so no hold actually in place and no strangle either. But just a worrying moment there for Naomi De Bruin. We hit the 2-minute mark of this 4-minute bout. This is the round of 16. A number of contestants will not have to fight in the first round because we only have 10 entries. But these girls at least will have to go through one more bout compared to some in the draw. They're both tumbling across the mat here, and De Bruin on top, but not really able to secure her position. So the women's under 78 kilogram division for athletes under 78 and over 63 kilograms. A limited number of weight divisions in this competition. De Bruin again fails to quite execute the throw as she wanted, and now on the ground, Wang in blue taking over. She's been the aggressor on the ground. Head reap from De Bruin. And loft rips. De Bruin goes over the top. Of course, the grip is the foundation for the throwing technique. You must have a good grip as De Bruin goes for it again. To date, no penalties. The referee has been happy with the genuine intent of all the throws. No false attacks, no drop downs without real technique and loss of grip. Lock grips again. De Bruin has a sleeve. So does Wang. And De Bruin tries to get into position. She suddenly finds Wang likewise counter-attacking with a throw of her own, but neither are able to pivot underneath the other, getting close enough, get the leverage required. You only have 19 seconds left. There's no positive score and there's no penalty. So this is going right down to the wire. Can one of these two break the deadlock in these last few seconds? Only 8 seconds left now. We might be going to golden score in our first bout of the day. Early leg reap there from the girl from Chinese Taipei. Now the Australian on her face. And we have no score. No positive attacking scores and no Shido. So immediately into golden score in this women's under 78 kilogram match between Naomi De Bruin of Australia in the white and Wang Yu Yun of Chinese Taipei in the blue. And De Bruin takes over on top, but Wang make sure there's no point of entry towards the hold. He gives a screen. Now remembering that the moment there is a successful attack of any grade or a penalty, just one penalty will mean victory and defeat here. It will be instant victory the moment there is a score or a penalty. They're a match for each other, these two. 30 seconds into golden score. Wang tried the leg reap, found the counter-attack coming from De Bruin, but then Wang really on top as they both fell down, but it was on their face and there was no thought of a score. Originally a 4-minute bout, now well into the first minute of golden score, and they're both off balance. Wang teetering for a moment, but De Bruin couldn't bring her over and down. Now, the referee may be making a decision here. Had a glance at the judges as well. There could be a penalty about to be issued. The referee wants the judogis to be tidy before a decision, I think, will be handed down. 52 seconds into golden score. I don't think we're going to continue. Who has the decision gone to? This may be a Shido penalty against one for being insufficiently active. Just a little too defensive in posture for the referee's liking. They're still awaiting the judogi to be completely retired. Decision. Penalty. Shido penalty against Wang Jujun. And the winner is Naomi De Bruin of Australia in the white. Naomi De Bruin wins the first bout in golden score. Winner by Shido. Shido against her opponent, Wang of Chinese Taipei. And confirming that result in golden score, Naomi De Bruin through to the next round, quarterfinal round. We see some of the action, which provided no positive score, only a penalty in golden score.
So it's Poland versus Venezuela here. 178 kilogram division. Camila Pasternak doing everything she can to motivate herself for this against Alisma Rodriguez. Poland in white, Venezuela in the blue. So we're away in this first round contest. The lady's 17 years of age. Rodriguez immediately trying to pick up her opponent and turn her over onto her back. Score of some description, perhaps not too far away. Very aggressive in her intent. Very smart Rodriguez. Referee gets involved and there's no score. Gold in the South American under 18 championships in the under 70 weight division last year. So up in grade, but in control early with the Wazari. Rodriguez, that was a great throw. Not the maximum effect, but very close. And a good start. That scoreboard looks nice for Venezuela. The opponent from Poland, Camila, or Kama, as she likes to be called, Pasternak, has gold, silver, and bronze from the European Continental Cadets, again in the under, no, that was in the over 70 division, so I know she's strong, Pasternak. And, almost able to get the throw, unable to get back up again, giving her opponent the opportunity for a stranglehold around the neck, but could not land it. Pasternak, gold in 2012, silver in 2013, and bronze in 2014 in the over 70 kilogram division of the European Cadets Championships, two-time national champion winner. So they're well credentialed. Teetering on the edge of the mat. In continuous movement, play will continue, and it certainly does. That was powerful, and it's all over. Elvisma Rodriguez. It appeared to be just a matter of time, didn't it? Just too strong in the end. It took her opponent off balance and then really hammered her into the mat. Nice way to move through the opening round. Winner by Ippon. Venezuela. Elvisma Rodriguez. We'll see both these girls again. Rodriguez continues in the search for gold and silver. Pasternak into the double repertoire.
The next bout at Longjiang Gymnasium is a men's under 100 kilogram semi-final. We only have four men entered in this weight category, and immediately therefore we are into a semi-final, and the winner will be into the gold medal match. These two big men, Ramin Savefeye of Iran in the white, and Dominic Schoenfeld of Germany in the blue. And the attack with a leg hook from Savavia, but all of a sudden he found himself being driven down over the top by Schoenfeld. Schoenfeld able to unbalance Savavia, who took the initiative with the leg attack. A 4 minute bout. And look at the strength of the German here. Schoenfeld on the edge of the contest area, but very strong. Schoenfeld from Hanover in Germany came fifth at the World Championships. Savafie took a bronze at the World Championships in 2013, and also a bronze at the Asian Championships last year in the age division, cadets. Both very strongly built characters, particularly considering their age. Both of them 18 years old. A grip high on the shoulder from Schoenfeld with his left hand, and driven down onto his front by the strength of Savavia, but quickly countering, and Schoenfeld takes over. Now he'll try and turn his man over. Savavia in that vulnerable position on his front side on all fours, just covering up. Schoenfeld, look at him getting underneath, trying to get some purchase. Can't do it. Coming up towards the midway point of this 4 minute bout. It's a men's semi-final in the over 81 and under 100 kilogram division. Over 81 and under 100. That's quite a span. Schoenfeld weighing in at 91 kilograms. Savafie at 100 kilograms. Savafie the heavier and also the tallest man in the competition. Stands 195 centimeters, so just a fraction under 2 meters. He's very tall, both imposing figures. Schoenfeld himself is 185 centimeters. And they've certainly demonstrated their strength. Now, who has the better technique to establish a positive score here? Because as yet, we have had no score and no penalties. You see the referee looking very carefully on at the maneuvers of both men. The referee himself is much shorter. He can almost see up underneath the chins of both athletes. Here's an attempted hip throw from Schoenfeld, unsuccessful. Now Savavie, Ramin Savavie from Iran. In the white. Might be just starting to feel the effects of this bout a little. Has he got the energy? Because so much strength is being used up by both men defensively. Just see Savathio there, put his hands on his knees for a moment. Just wondering if he's starting to get a little tired here. Now Schoenfeld has him almost off balance, trying to break his balance. He goes now down onto the ground, tries to turn him over. 41 seconds remaining. This is very even. The German appears to have the upper hand, but he hasn't been able to score. When I say the upper hand, just in these later stages, only 30 seconds remaining. There is still no penalty on the board, and there is no positive score. The German working away at the arm, and still no score. Oh, Ramin Savafie slowly to his feet, though, taking every second. Dominik Schoenfeld of Germany comes forward, has the grip. Brings his man down, but on the front side again, no score. And the referee breaks them up. So only 13 seconds now. Schoenfeld looks more dangerous, but can he do it here and now before golden score? He takes the cross grip. Savafie gripping underneath, and that could be a score. No, it's not ruled a score. Time is up on the clock. So we are going into golden score. The referee is just going to take a time. Maybe we won't. Is it golden score? It is golden score. So 4 minutes elapse without any attacking result, nor penalty. We go into unlimited time in golden score. And immediately the attack comes from Savafie. No score though. You would think that Ramin Savafie, if he is feeling the effects of this long bout, you'd think he would want to attack now, because I don't know if he's going to last a long time. The German looks stronger so far. Here is Savafie with the attack. He's got the leg hook. They're fighting for balance. Who's going to go over? Oh, it's a German going down, but then he brings his man over. No score for all that. Oh, it looked as if in the end Savafie was in trouble. He was being brought around by Schoenfeld, but he couldn't get him onto his side. He landed flat on his face. The referee is going to continue. As soon as there is a Shido penalty here, if that is the case, that would mean victory just as much as a Yuko or a Wazari. Once again, legwork from Savafie. If he was tiring before, he's still going strong at the moment. And I think both men now equally are feeling the effects of this as much as Savafie. Leans over, puts his hands on his knees. The referee actually now is calling them to tidy the judogi, so we may have a decision here. Referee might be going to step in. Still no positive scores, no attacking scores. I have a feeling that the referee, in consultation with the other officials, is about to declare a penalty. Which way will it go? Who will be the winner? This is a semi-final, remember. The winner goes into the gold medal match. It may be on the referee's decision here. Both Ishido against the German. He's stunned. Dominik Schoenfeld can't believe that he's been penalized. The winner is Ramin Savafie of Iran. And Savafie is the victor. It looked as if he might have been tiring in the regular time, late in the 4 minutes, but he seemed to get another burst of energy. Schoenfeld started to weaken, just a touch in golden score. It was an even battle, nothing in it, but decided on the Shido penalty awarded in golden score against Dominik Schoenfeld. The winner is Ramin Savafie of Iran, and he is through to the gold medal match.
Kazakhstan and Argentina now as the big boys move on to the mat. This is a semi-final in the 100 kilogram division. In white, Rostislav Dashkov. In blue, Gustavo Basile. More natural of the heavyweights is Dashkov, as you can see. Just 16 years of age, though. Doesn't turn 17 till October. This is a massive stage. And a heavy weight. Basile, 18. Only form we can find for the Argentinian is a one win, one loss in the over 90 kilogram division at the Cadet World Championships last year. And we did win a bronze medal in the Pan American under 21s in the under 100 kilogram division in San Salvador in July. There's form on both sides. Dashkov, a silver medalist at the Asian Continental Championships in 2012. And then he was seventh at the World Cadet Champs last year. The big boys just sorting themselves out at the moment. Dashkov, Bishkek. From Kyrgyzstan. Basile from Buenos Aires. We know a bit about them now. And then we start to get a feel for how they attack. This is the attempted scarf hold from Basile, searching for a point as we edge towards the halfway mark. And the referee looked at the judges there. I'm not sure, is there a penalty coming? There may be. Well, that wasn't, well, it looked to be very close to the signal for a penalty. Referee waiting for the judges to look at the tape. There you can see whether that scarf hold that Basile placed on Dashkov was worthy of a point. Didn't hold it for long, and there was certainly no submission. So the two judges are looking at the tape, the two coaches as perplexed as the two athletes, and maybe the referee in the middle. And we play on. No penalty, no, the penalty comes now. In fact, he's been disqualified. Automatic disqualification goes against Gustavo Basile, and the victory and the certain medal now, a gold or silver assured, depends how he goes in the final, for Rostislav Dashkov. So winner by Ippon is the official score. There are 140 different ways, and I kid you not with that number, for the technical term for each bout to be decided, and I'm not sure exactly what that was, but the judges had to look for it. And now off camera the coach is talking to the referee, so there may be an appeal, who knows. But as it stands right now, you're looking at the gold medal contest coming up later on.
The women's under 78 kilogram quarterfinal about to begin, featuring Morgan Deschaine from France. She's up against Naomi De Bruin of Australia in the white. So Deschaine in the blue, De Bruin in the white. This is the first bout in the women's under 78 kilogram division for Deschaine. She had a bye in the round of 16. Just 10 entries in the women's competition. This is the second bout for De Bruin. De Bruin had to go through golden score in her first match. And the throw is good. The throw is good from Morgane Duchesne. The French woman scores Ippon. She's an imposing figure. Duchesne. And the winner by Ippon in quick time. Only 50 seconds of the 4 minutes had elapsed. And with beautiful technique, she put De Bruin out of the running for the gold medal anyway. De Bruin can come back through repercharge, but Morgane Duchesne, from France, winner by Ippon, and did it in fine style. She has the longer legs and she used them as great levers here. Look at that perfect technique, crashing her opponent down onto her back.
You see one of the favourites here in the women's 78 kilogram division in action in blue. Aleksandra Samardžić, Bosnia Herzegovina. Two-time gold medalist in the Euro Cup in the seniors. She's against Sara Rodriguez of Spain in the white. And immediately on the attack, trying to get that grip up high. Give us all a look and certainly give her opponent a look at how she's been able to compete in open age company. From Sarajevo, in fact one of those victories, the Euro Cup victories came in Sarajevo in March. One in Belgrade last year. Both in the under 70 kilogram division, so up a little bit in weight. He has got the arm lock, that is impressive. Lucky that the arm's still attached there. And as she took her opponent down, Samardžić, she got an automatic boost of confidence, not so on the scoreboard, but you do get the impression that will come. Rodriguez herself, a five-time gold medalist in the Euro Cup, but at the cadets level, the under 18 level. Also a world championship bronze medalist at the cadets level, the under 18s level, and that's what the Youth Olympics is. It's for athletes 14 to 18 years of age, so very much at home, but up against a steely opponent here. Really working well, the Spaniard. She's been around for longer than her opponent, Rodriguez, 18 years of age, and 18 in January, Samardžić, 16. So the lady in blue, she's a star on the rise. Despite potentially giving away a little bit of weight here. She's at home on the Youth Olympic mat, that's for sure. Still no score. Spain and Bosnia Herzegovina. Both of these ladies were given a bye in the first round. Such is their form, and all of a sudden, Samardžić might be starting to think about why she's still out here. By the form she's brought in, doesn't necessarily equate. That's often the way at Olympic level and Youth Olympic level here in Nanjing in 2014. It's a completely different stage. And a Shido penalty awarded against the Spaniard, against Rodriguez there. As some of the competitors in the women's under 63 kilogram division up on the screen. Some of the medalists that are here watching on. Excited like the rest of the crowd here at the Longjiang Gymnasium You want to get excited about this bout, but it's been very strategic, very tactical so far. And here's another example. Neither able to get a dominant grip. And we come back into the middle of the mat. So the one Shido penalty against Rodriguez, well, that's enough to give Samardzic the victory. Referee again quick to call the girls back in to the middle of the mat. Last minute advice perhaps. It's going to help now. Rodriguez certainly has to pull something out with the second Shido against her now. But she has to attack. Penalized for not attacking enough. And going to ground when under the pump. And now attempting to put the stranglehold on is Samardzic. Pulls to her feet. Looks at the clock. And there's her path to continue towards the gold medal here in Nanjing 2014. He's very, very close. Time for one more move, perhaps, from Rodriguez. Unable to do it. Off the mat they go. They'll come back into the middle. Unless the referee calls something here that we didn't notice. 16-year-old is moving through. And that's time. We'll wait for official notification. Alexandra Samardzic. ...179 centimetres of her. That resolve on her face as she looks up to her countrymen and women in the stands. Not sure that she'll celebrate this. She's all business. She's got more to do. And for Rodriguez, we'll see her again into the repercharge in the chase for gold. Wait for official confirmation. Just thought so much about respect. Discipline of martial arts, of course, very much in vogue here. So the judogi is tidied up. The belt is on. And the left hand rises from the referee. And with that, Samardzic moves through. Bosnia Herzegovina continues in the women's 78 kilogram division. Nanjing 2014. Just the two Shido penalties, the difference there against the Spaniard. She was really on the defensive through much of the match, wasn't she, trying to stay in it. She did a very good job at that, but unable to land a blow to get on the scoreboard.
Women's under 78 kilogram quarterfinal about to take place here at Longjiang Gymnasium. In the white, Sophie Berger from Belgium is against Unel Sneeman of South Africa. Now, Sneeman, you can see, considerably taller than her opponent. She's 184 centimeters. That's the tallest in the women's competition here in this weight division. And using that leg to hook around. But in the end, she is the one who is unbalanced, and Berger takes over in the dominant position, going for the hold. Sneeman trying to provide as little opportunity to penetrate as possible, and Sneeman avoids the difficult situation there. So that might be the pattern we will see. Will Sneeman continue to use the legs, and will Berger be able to counterattack? They stand away from each other. Now it is Sneeman who reaches in to take the grip on the lapel. Berger with the grip over the top now. The attempt from Sneeman to try and use the leverage of her legs to pull her opponent off balance. Quarterfinal bout. The South African in the blue. She hooks the leg again, but can't complete the technique. Plenty of activity so far in this bout. They're not going to stand off, and the referee won't want them to, as it's a driving takedown from Berger, but in the end, Sneeman from South Africa again able to land on her front side, so no score. Four minutes of competition here. Sophie Berger, maybe the shorter of the athletes, but she looks in no way overawed by her opponent. So it is a little bit more awkward for her. It also provides opportunities, though, against a taller opponent to get under them, to pivot on the hip, to get close and under them. We have a slight injury here. Oh, it's a contact lens. Sophie Berger has lost a contact lens. The Belgian girl just is able to replace it, and she's right to continue. Just inside the second 2 minutes. And there's a throw, and the counter comes from the Belgian. Again, it's Sneeman initiating it. The Belgian trying to counter, but really she was the loser of the battle, but not of a score. Plunged onto her front side to avoid trouble. Here's trouble, though. This is trouble, surely. Wazari scores. Wazari scores. The referee has ruled Wazari. It's still not on the board, but you can see the legwork and then the drive over the top. And she was coming down on her back. The referee is having another look at it. The other officials are checking it. And the Wazari ruled, yes, Wazari in favor of Sneeman. She used the leg to get her opponent off balance and drove over the top of her and was able to take her down on her back. And she goes for it again here. She comes down just on the front of her side rather than on the side. No score. So Berger's in a bit of trouble here, and now she's in real trouble as Sneeman goes for the hold. But out of the contest area. So we're approaching the final minute of this bout, and it seems the longer we go, the more that Sneeman is just able to use those legs to her advantage. Those long limbs. Must be at least 10, if not 15 centimeters taller in the legs. Wazari scoring for Sneeman, and so now Sophie Berger trailing and needs to initiate the attack and needs to make the technique stick. Berger also with Ashido against her, so it's all out attack now from the lady in white. 17-year-old, but Sneeman protecting her position. She doesn't need to be aggressive here, Sneeman. She can be a little more defensive now. Berger trying to get an effective grip, and you can see there that Sneeman quite happy to go face down on the mat. Front side down, and so you need to be a little careful not to concede any penalties, but with only 8 seconds to go, she just doesn't want to put herself in any perilous position. She stays out of danger, and there is the end of the contest in favour of Unelle Sneeman of South Africa. We'll wait for confirmation of that result. But scoring with the Wazari. She is the winner, Unelle Sneeman of South Africa. Wins the quarterfinal by Wazari, goes through to the semi-finals now, and a smile. She knows that she has a very real chance of a medal now. Good performance by her. She used her physical skills and technique to eventually dominate her opponent. Winnell Sneeman of South Africa goes through to the semi-final. And you can see the way she used that leg for leverage and then drove over opponent, kept her on her back, took her down, just using a full body weight to come through after the leg hook.
Venezuela in white, Croatia. One of the favourites. There she is, the favourites of the women's 78 kilogram division of the Judo Nanjing 2014 on the floor. Vizma Rodriguez of Venezuela against Brigita Matic of Croatia. The taller of the two by some way. The tail of the tape says 182 centimetres or 6 foot in white versus 168. Also a little older is the Croatian, and a lot more powerful you would imagine. A bronze medalist at senior level on the Grand Prix circuit in the under 78, this weight division. Also a bronze medalist in the Euro Cup seniors in the same weight division in Sarajevo in March. So competing against bigger girls and heavier girls and her opponent at the moment, but Rodriguez in blue. That's the dominant position. Makes Matic work for this. Brigita, or Gigo, as she likes to be called, that's her nickname. She had the bye in the first round. Rodriguez coming for a win by Ippon against Poland. So we're a minute in. And importantly, no score. See those long levers. Keen to get a grip up high and throw her opponent over the shoulder. Shinagi, shoulder throw. Very quickly lead to an Ippon, an instant victory. And goes to her knees. Must be careful there. When under attack, if you go to your knees too quickly, too defensively, you can be penalised. Not on this occasion. Gigo Matic. Ooh, he's under some pressure there. Got the arm hold, Rodriguez. Very quick move, explosive move, powerful move. And what sort of a hold does she have down there? No, nothing that produces a score, but gee, the Croatian stage. This may be back at underage level. Of course, the Youth Olympics for athletes aged 14 to 18. And once again, Venezuelan on the charge. And the stranglehold, unable to land it. We're just beyond the halfway mark now. Lavisma Rodriguez, gold medalist in the South American Under 18 Championships last year at under 70. So she's stepping up a bit and feeling the full force of her opponent there. And really going hard, looking for the chokehold there. Just forcing every part of her body. Matic on top of her opponent. But again, no score. And in fact, the Shido penalty goes against the Croatian. Just checking, the referee checking with the judges. And there's a Yuko there. So it was a forceful choke. Just the minor score, just the Yuko, so that usurps the penalty. She's not in control, far from it, as the face crashes into the mat there. Vizma Rodriguez, 17-year-old from Caracas, is really working hard, but again under pressure here. Well, in this position, she is dominant. Matic, the strength there for all to see. Looking for submission now, trying to stretch the leg as well, and we wonder whether there's a score coming. I think there is. Referee checking with the judges. And back to the middle, and no score. Really having to earn it. Jigo Matic from Croatia. He's finished high school. He's looking to take her opponent to task here and maybe teach her a lesson. Just going to get out of school early on this one. It might go all the way to the bell. Again, in the dominant position, what's that chokehold like? Trying to force her opponent into submission. And coach just being told to quieten down. And the girl's going okay. Don't blow it. Venezuelan team very much aware of what's happening here with just 30 seconds to go. Oh, almost the throw. The drop Cienagi attempt from Rodriguez, unable to land it. Really having to earn it here is Brigida Matic. Has to be careful. Only a slender lead. It's possible to defend it from here, but in this sport, you're quickly penalised if you go on the defensive, failed to attack. And she did drop to her knees there quickly. With Matic, it's a long way from the top. Yep, and is penalised from that, 182 centimetres. She is for the second Cienagi, the second Shido penalty. My apologies, doesn't matter because of the Yuko score. And there is the bell. Gee, it was hard work. It was very hard work all the way to the end. Now that's classic Youth Olympic Games. The 17-year-old from Venezuela against the 18-year-old, a senior medalist from Croatia. And she took her all the way to the end. Great contest. We'll wait for the judogi Rodriguez to be tidied up again. Keeping her emotions in check. What would have gone through her mind in the previous 4 minutes? And there it is. There's the winner by the minor Yuko score, Brigida Matic. Have a look at those highlights. Gee, she fought so well, Rodriguez. Matic, a couple of times, so close to a submission hold, really working the body, working everything that she had there. Just couldn't get the grip, couldn't get the takedown. Took some punishment, but has survived and has the victory. So that's where we're at. The repercharge to follow shortly. France, Bosnia and Herzegovina, Croatia involved. And the girls will be given some chance now to rest and recover before the draw is cut in half. So the winners go through to continue on their search for gold and silver. And the losers, they regroup, they're redrawn as you saw, and they will continue on in the search for bronze. Two bronze medals and the full repercharge in the women's under 78 kilogram division. It's been a wonderful competition so far and it will continue in Nanjing 2014. Share the games, share our dreams, the Youth Olympics.
Repeating that we are about to go into the repercharge matches in the women's under 78 kilogram weight category, but there is a mandatory period of rest between the previous bout and the next for those contestants. The next match should feature and will feature Wang of Chinese Taipei against Sarah Rodriguez of Spain. Competition continuing now at Longjiang Gymnasium. We have a women's under 78 kilogram repercharge quarterfinal between in white Wang Yuyun of Chinese Taipei and in blue from Spain, Sarah Rodriguez. They're coming into the repercharge quarterfinal, both having lost previously. Wang losing in the round of 16. And then Sarah Rodriguez, remembering there are two Rodriguez competing in the women's event here in this under 78, Elvis Ma and also Sarah, but this is Sarah Rodriguez of Spain. Elvis Ma Rodriguez is from Venezuela. Spaniard, quite strongly built. In fact, you could say both competitors match a match for each other in terms of both have that strength about them. Attempted drop down from Sarah Rodriguez, going for the shoulder throw without success. Wan Shido ruled against Wang of Chinese Taipei, so she'll have to be more aggressive, and she is immediately stung into action. She stamps on the ground, though, a little frustrated. She wants to go after her opponent, but Rodriguez had her back to her, going back to her position. So all of a sudden, Wang has been annoyed, you might say. That's my interpretation. I'm annoyed by that Shido against her, and she's not going to get a second one. She's going to be much more active and positive from here on. She ducks forward there, covers up now. Sarah Rodriguez, in a previous bout, found herself against a taller opponent. Now, possibly enjoying the fact that she may be a fraction taller than Wang Yuyun of Chinese Taipei in the white, both attempting legwork here. And in the end, it is Rodriguez who goes face down. No score, of course. Another Shido, though, ruled against Wang. Into the last 2 minutes of this 4 minute repercharge quarterfinal. See who will continue fighting for a bronze medal. Wang becoming more aggressive. She must initiate a positive attack here and score. She has two Shidos against her, so she's down on penalties, and she's attempting to take the fight to Sarah Rodriguez, but Rodriguez seems to be able to match everything that comes her way so far. They lock grips momentarily, head to head again, in close. Wang, oh, the leg hook is good from Rodriguez, but she couldn't bring down Wang onto her side. The throw must land the opponent on the side or back to score. This time, Wang finds herself going down as she appeared to initiate, trying to drop down and take her opponent with her. It's 50-50 really in the end. Rodriguez on top, but can't apply a hold. Wang is slow to her feet, with just over a minute remaining. Sara Rodriguez of Spain in the blue. Her opponent down on penalties. Wang Yujun of Chinese Taipei. Oh, loss of balance from Rodriguez, but she was stumbling backwards. Stayed out of trouble initially. Now she's going for the arm lock. She's going for a lock in there. Seconds to go in this Repechage quarterfinal. A good throw this time, and it scores. Yes, it's Ippon. Referee signals Ippon for Sara Rodriguez of Spain. Quick move, caught her opponent by surprise. Wang brought down on her back. And what had been a scoreless match up until that point, when it came to initiating positive attacks, scoring attacks, suddenly, in the wink of an eye, an Ippon for Rodriguez. So her dreams of a bronze medal here at Nanjing 2014 are still alive. Winner in the blue. Sara Rodriguez, winner by Ippon for Spain. Over Wang Yujun of Chinese Taipei. Winner by Ippon goes down in the books. Rodriguez will go through to the Repechage semi-final. That was the technique, shoulder throw, nicely executed. Dropping down, good grip, bring your opponent down, belly firmly on her back, and the coach liked it.